Coming in there is Miss Liz and Miss Audra. Shelby's carpet.
Hello.
Say good morning.
Good morning.
You guys want to show us around a little bit?
You bet.
Have an idea what you got going on?
Yep, I will just start you out with some of our carpets we've got here. We've got your Mohawk, we've got Shaw, we've got your Anderson Cuffex. Do want you to know that we've got some displays here where we've got our nylons, we've got our polyesters here, we've got some of our prints, one of our favorites here. This is for your stairs. If you'd like to do a stair runner, I can make a stair runner for you.
Is the prints coming back?
Yes, they are.
Are they really?
They're beautiful. And we do custom bind. Remember that. If you come in here and you've got hardwood floors and you want an area rug, we can custom bind that for you.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Also, I'm just taking you around to our commercial carpet display. If you've got a sunroom or if you've got an office, a business, we do also commercial jobs. We've got carpet tiles and broadloom. Got our at least two or three displays here when we do that. And we also do ceramic tile remodels. We also do backsplashes. So, my favorite, if you have a tub that needs to be taken out, even a ceramic tile or a just a regular acrylic tub, and you want to come back with a walk-in shower, or just a tub surround, I can help you decorate that and customize that for you.
Liz, are you seeing a lot of remodeling going on there?
More than ever. People coming in, new construction, but a lot of remodeling. And they're coming in here and they did not know that Chubby's did ceramic tile remodels. So that's what we're doing a lot of now.
Well, I've heard a lot of people talking about redoing their kitchens and baths, so that's a fact.
We do, and a lot of people are actually taking out their old countertops and putting in granite, and we're coming back and I'm helping them coordinate their granite to a new backsplash.
Gotcha.
So yeah, we do a lot of that.
We all stay plenty busy.
Yes, we do.
You do some of everything.
We do. So we actually do. I like to show people a lot of our tiles. We have a lot of custom tiles here. Porcelain. We've got some glass that we also use. I like to use a lot of these accent pieces when I'm creating your new shower, your new Listello. We also can install your niche in the back of your shower so you have a special place for your shampoo and conditioner. We've also got stone here if you want to do your fireplace. So we've got a nice array of stone here to look at.
And Miss Audra's over there on the newest product you got.
This is my assistant Audra. Hello. She helps me sell a lot of the newest floor today is luxury vinyl plank. And this is Mannington's Aduramax. We sell more of this. It's an 8mm product. It is scratch resistant, water resistant, has a lifetime residential, has a 10-year light commercial. We just put it in this huge hardware store. So it's tough.
Yeah, I've heard a lot of people talking about that. That's kind of the hottest thing on the street right now in the construction industry.
Yep, and it comes in 12 by 24 tiles. Just know that this is a floating floor. The great thing about it, if you've got vinyl on the floor now and you don't want to do a lot of prep work to it, you can float this right across your floor.
Does it click, pop, and snap when people are walking on it?
No. That's one thing it will not do. It's not going to do like with a laminate, what we've always used to hear in the echoey tap, tap sound that it gives. This is going to be more of a solid, and it's actually warmer. And most of my new construction, about 90% of my new construction, this is what they're doing.
Gotcha.
Instead of hardwood floors, because of their grandbabies. Because of the kids, because of the dogs, the cats, they don't have to worry about it. So we got tile looks for your bathrooms, kitchens, utility rooms. Then we've got all these wood planks.
Quite a variety.
Warm, nice cool grays if you want to do that. a lot of beachy looks for a lot of the beach houses. Mm-hmm. It's beautiful. We've also got it in the water plank form, mm-hmm. if you want to do that. And I don't want people to forget that if you don't want to do a luxury vinyl plank, we've got vinyl sheet goods.
Gotcha.
Most of our vinyl sheet goods come 12 foot. You can get 13-2 wide, which is really cool mm-hmm. because it's good for your single wides or your double wides or your modulars. So we customize and help you do that so you won't have seams in your vinyl.
So you guys can help most anybody with your flooring needs.
Yeah, you bet.
Well, that's good.
It's
a one-stop shop.
And I'll show you one more thing that we do.
All right.
We customize and pre-finish hardwood floors.
Customize and pre-finish?
Yep, pre-finished.
So okay.
We've got your hickories, your acacias, your maples. I've got your standard white oak, your red oak. If you want to do an engineered or if you want to do a solid, we take pride in this particular brand because of it being a half-inch engineered. And it's made in the USA.
Well, that's awesome. What kind of warranties it got with it?
This has a 50-year structural warranty on it.
That's great.
Yeah.
Well, guys, we appreciate your time today. And
thank you.
If you need anything in the flooring, come see these gals.
Come see us at Chubby's.
We'll do it. And thank you. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I do want to show you their board with all their projects they have going on as we speak. And they can get to you. So guys, appreciate it. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Hey guys, this is Ross at Avalanche Motorsports in Washington, North Carolina. And today we're doing our review of the flagship of the C-Fox fleet, the C-Fox 328 Commander. Come on, let's go take a look. Okay guys, the first thing that I want to show you on this C-Fox is the massive Carolina flare that it has. Makes this boat a super dry ride. Going over a few quick measurements, the boat measures exactly 32 feet long. It has a 10-foot, 8-inch beam and a dead rise of 22.5 degrees. This is an offshore machine that's capable for anything that you want to throw at. Okay, moving on, we want to talk a little bit about the hull of the C-Fox. First of all C-Foxes are built in Monk's Corner, South Carolina. These boats aren't just designed, but they're engineered to be safe and last a lifetime. That's why C-Fox was one of the first boat manufacturers out there to offer a lifetime hull warranty. There's no wood in this boat, which means there's not gonna be any type of rot. C-Fox utilizes high quality 316 stainless steel through hole fittings, and the 328 boasts the notched hull back design, which will give you the best performance possible. Now, at the back of the boat, C-Fox has integrated a dive door. And what makes C-Fox different from a lot of boat builders is a lot of boat builders will design a hull and then cut a hole in it and put a door. C-Fox designs the hull around the door so you have lots of structure and backing in there to assure that you don't run into spider cracking and issues like that down the road. Moving to the back of the boat here, we see this boat is powered with twin Yamaha digital 300s. Max horsepower on this boat is 700, so you could do 350s. This boat as it sits is about a 52, 53 mile an hour boat with the 350s, 57 mile an hour boat. Back here you have a lot of attention to detail and design. C-Fox recesses all of their trim tabs on all their boats from 22 feet and up. And here you have your built-in integrated dive ladder so you can get on and off easy. This is where I want to spend all my time at when I'm on this boat, is back here in the area. C-Fox is famous for having a boat that's extremely comfortable to have the family thing going on in the front and fishing in the back, and this just tells the tale. Back here you have a big comfortable bench seat, but with the flip of a lever, you've got a full combing device that you can lean up to and really get into the fish with. You have two large pressurized bait wells, keep your bait living for a long time and easy to get to, with an aquarium style live well over here as well. Now, down by your dive door, you have an insulated cooler box, which is nice. You can throw some drinks and water in there when you're going swimming. And then when you're ready to pull the big fish in, you've got four large macerated fish boxes here. With a total of 36 rod holders on this boat, C-Fox definitely made this boat for the fishermen. All right, back here is the bait prep station. As you can see, this was really well thought out. You've got a flat area here, but you flip this over, you've got a cutting board, you have an area where you can keep your bait once it's all prepped and set up. You also have a sink here with a freshwater wash down as well. Then underneath, they did a really good job utilizing this space. All you have to do is press a button and you've got easy access to your Yeti cooler. When you start opening compartments in this Sea Fox 328 Commander, you can tell that this boat was made for the angler. You have a really nice tackle station with drawers and line set up. Storage all through this center console area, and raw water wash down on this side and another fresh water wash down over on the starboard side. Okay guys, in the helm area, the first thing that you'll notice are these three comfortable race boat inspired LeBrock seats. There's several different armrest configurations and setups for using this as a leaning post or just cruising, with several areas to put your seat. If you can't get comfortable in this helm, then you can't get comfortable. Moving up to the hard top, this has a ton of storage in it. You have storage to the rear and up front. You have an acrylic glass panel here so you can mount a VHF radio. And when it comes to climate control in this boat features freshwater misters here and back here, and also has air conditioning that actually comes out of the console area and will keep you cool on those August days. Okay, touching some more on the helm area, everything is very smartly laid out already from Sea Fox. You've got two huge Garmin 7616 GPS units in here that'll provide you with medium, high chirp, fish finder, depth finder, everything you need to get on the fish and know where you're going. You got a smart switch panel down here that has everything you need access to. You have your Yamaha control center, EPS, and JL audio, all within hand's reach. Also, this boat comes standard with the Lenco trim tabs with the LED indicator, so you always know where your trim tabs are. Also, something that I like about the 328 is you have battery switches right here, easy to get to. You're never going to hop in your boat and have forgotten to turn on your battery switches. Okay guys, as you can see here, the bow area has a ton of room. It is fishing friendly. However, all you have to do is snap in a few cushions and you've got a bow area for the most discerning of pleasure boaters. Look at this. You've got beautiful diamond stitching, super comfortable bow seating area, and with these snap back cushions, you can face forward or you can face facing backwards and have a nice conversation here, have your wine and cheese. It's all good to go. My favorite spot on the boat was back there in the bait area. This is my second favorite spot of the boat. Up front, beautiful view, and believe it or not, even in rough water, this seat rides good. Circling back around to this T-top, one thing that Sea Fox does is they build all of their T-tops in-house. This T-top is fabricated for this boat. It's not an afterthought. It's not something that's subbed out to a different company. This is a Sea Fox boat with a Sea Fox top on it. You've got integrated lights all the way around. You have awesome storage for fire extinguishers and Coast Guard safety equipment. You have your freshwater mister system, and you have brackets preset for taco outriggers. So all you have to do is basically bolt them up and they're ready to go. Guys, for those of you who know me, I'm not a small guy. Sea Fox does a great job of making plenty of walk around room around here. You can get easy access to any one of the 36 rod holders that are on this boat. And it's really set up for fishing. You have the ability to fish this boat anywhere that you want all the way around. I want you to take a look at the size of this console in this Sea Fox 328 Commander. You have an electric flushing head with overboard discharge. You have a large berth, and Sea Fox even air conditions this console. That's right, you have an air conditioner control that'll allow you to control the temperature in here. Super, super clean layout. You've got your amplifiers for your JL Audio sound system here. You have access to all your breakers, circuits, and switches, and then access to the back to get to your electronics. This was really well thought out and super useful. So ladies and gentlemen, in closing, if you're looking for a fishing machine that's capable of taking you anywhere you want to go, catching all the fish, but without sacrificing any type of luxury or comfort, you need to put the Seafox 328 Commander on your short list. And at Avalanche Motorsports, it costs less too.
Thanks for watching our video. If this information was helpful to you, click the like button and check out our inventory on avalanche-motors.com.
Here in Washington. Great tiki bar.
Well, I've been coming here since 2005, and it's day in, day out, it's the most consistent, best food in town.
Oh, I love hearing that. Thank you so much.
So,
come and see us.
Come see us. There we go. We're going to walk around and shoot everybody.
All right.
See the smiles on everybody's face. We're going to play the ring game.
Oh, wait, let it go.
Is it good?
Absolutely.
This
is the original.
1776. Make the ring for us. One dime. Great place for all ages. She's trying to knock the light pole down. She's getting directed. Overlooking the river. Backwater Jack. There we go, two stores. Lots of bar room, lots of people. Now we're gonna go watch the
Come on inside.
Huh?
Come on inside.
All right. Going on the inside. Absolutely. I remember it well. Ladies first.
Thank you.
I'm old school. That ain't changing.
Okay, give us a smile, Dylan. This is Dylan, the bartender of the night.
That's right.
Been wheeling, dealing, slinging drinks all around.
And I'll vouch for him. He makes a good drink. Lime and rum and 7-Up.
All right. That's what I'm talking about.
That's a great drink.
Yeah, I maybe wouldn't go all the way in,
but
you probably
could.
Don't go all the way
in. Yeah, just enough to see.
There,
this is where all the good food comes from.
Can you turn it off a second?
Huh?
So I can pull out some the crew.
No, I really can't, but go ahead. We'll keep shooting. Even got TV. See what the weather's going to be tomorrow. Got an ATM machine. No credit cards. Bring your car and get cash and pay for a great experience and good food. Here we go.
Okay.
Alrighty.
As soon as they got a minute, they're going to come out.
Alright.
And give them a big wave. There's two guys working hard at the grill right now.
Hey, they did a great. That chicken sandwich is awesome.
Their griddle is not any wider than this.
Really?
And they put all that food out of that kitchen.
I'm not a big fan of chicken.
There they go.
Come on, my baby. Say
this
hey.
Is Jess.
Come here and say hey. Don't be bashful. We all do a great job. Thank you. All right, walk through the here. Walk through the dining room.
You want to go through this way?
Yeah. I know that fella, Mr. Merle Moore.
Yes, sir.
How you doing, man?
We're always glad when you bring your crew in.
How's it going?
Good, how you doing?
Been a while.
Good Mr. Max?
Yeah.
Mike Baker, you ain't recognize me.
Mike!
Yeah, man.
God.
How you doing?
Hey.
I know it.
Going with the wind.
Man, we're getting a little older now.
I know me.
Things change.
So what are you up to nowadays? Retired?
Oh, yeah. No, man. Having fun.
I hear you.
Right now you're on YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter. Yeah, we're kind of shooting a thing for the guys here.
It's like Midnight and Ninjas.
Yeah. Remember that? I was at the truck ride the other night. That was awesome. Yeah, man. Catch up with me a little bit. I've seen bro twice today. What did I see you do?
I don't think so.
Did he? Yeah, look at that. That's having fun at Backwater Jack.
You better know it.
Yeah. Everybody in here is quiet. They're eating. Or have eaten, taking a nap. Here we are going to the bar area. You got pretty red hair. How you doing?
Hey guys, today we're at Avalanche Motorsports and we're going to talk about the all new 2018 Sea Fox 266 Commander. So this boat screams Sea Fox. Big flared out bow, signature stripe built into the hull. This particular boat is finished in aquamarine, which is a new color for 2018. We've got aquamarine under the hard top, white powder coating, white custom painted engines. Moving back here, of course we've got the recessed trim tab pockets, underwater LEDs. That's the LED package that comes with additional mood lighting inside the cockpit. This particular boat's equipped with twin 150 XB motors, super fuel efficient. I've got one of these boats myself. It averages about 3 miles to the gallon, cruising at about 3,500 RPMs. Makes for a great package. This boat is also available starting with a single 300 motor. We can also do a 350. Of course, again, this boat's got twin 150s. It's available with 200s as well in both XB and XCA configurations. So as I move aboard this boat, right here just in front of the motor well area, we've got an optional ski tow bar. We've got four large rod holders here. I'm standing on a pass-through jump seat. It folds up and down. We've got a nice stepped area here to make entry and exit super easy. Just between the two jump seats, we've got a 55-gallon aerated live well. And it's round. It's going to do a great job keeping the bait alive. So just in front of the live well here, we've got this rear jump seat with a combing board. While you're fishing, you can fold this flat. Makes for a larger available space back here. For cruising, we'll fold it up so we have additional seating. Just under this is access to all your pumps. It's fully finished, fully gel coated. Just in front of this area, we've got two large hatches here. These are your insulated, macerated fish boxes. We'll move forward. We've got additional rod holders here in the leaning post. We got them all throughout the gunwale. This particular leaning post, my favorite position is with the bolsters folded up, used as a leaning post rather than a seat. This is the most comfortable position to me, but you can fold them down and you do have a footrest here. All brand new helm for 2018. They removed the center pod with all the switches and gauges and laid everything out below. Gave us a additional space for twin screens up to 16 inch. We've got your switch panel down here. Super easy to get to, command link gauges. These particular motors again are mechanical, so this is standard. Your standard Kicker 8 speaker stereo, that is a Bluetooth model. We've got a C-Star tilt helm. Of course this boat's equipped with two motors, so this is your dual binnacle. Just below that we've got some a glove box here with charging access and audio input. Alright, rod holders. So we've got seven out back here. We've got two kings, five center.
This new hard top has four storage boxes, one forward, one aft, two on each side of the boat. It also has four spreader lights all the way around. It is pre-rigged for Taco outriggers. They did carry over the freshwater misting system that is standard in the hardtop. And this new sunroof is awesome. It opens and shuts. It just makes for a great streamlined hardtop. So when I'm fishing, I'm wondering where all my equipment is. On this particular boat, there's gonna be no question. On the starboard side of the console here, they've got this great tackle station. This is standard on the 266. So we've got six Plano boxes. We've got a nice shelf here, a drawer, and we've got spools for your lines there. So today I'm not going fishing. I'm taking the family out. I moved all my stuff out of the boat. We're going boat riding. Look at the bow here. This thing is family friendly in the front. Scallop seating, stowaway backrest for ease pass through. Folds right into these combing boards on each side here. You've got storage under each side of these cushions. We've got a casting net bucket recessed into the floor here. And oh my God, look at this coffin box. You've got storage for days and super comfy chairs. So I'm down here in the console. This thing has got ample space, great access behind the helm. The tub here is fully finished, gel coat. We've got a freshwater sink. This particular boat that I'm in now has a electronic toilet with overboard discharge, which is a very popular option. And this is new as well. They've got the bow filler board stowed away up top here. So in short, if you're headed to the lake, the river, or going offshore fishing, this 266 Commander should definitely be on your short list. And in Avalanche Motorsports, starting just under $90,000 NAP pricing, it costs less too.
Thank you.
guys, it's Todd here with Avalanche Motorsports in Washington, North Carolina. And today we're going to talk about the all-new 2018 C-Fox 288 Commander. I want to point out the big broad bow here. This thing's got a ton of flair to it. They've integrated that Carolina flair. We've got a downward striking chine. This is a super dry riding boat. As you may or may not know, C-Fox is one of the only manufacturers on the market doing a lifetime hull warranty. That says we're confident in the product that we're building. This is a full composite boat. There's no wood, no rot, okay? There's a lot of manufacturers doing this, but it is a little bit of a fine line. C-Fox is actually doing composite stringers. It's a full composite boat. As we move back here, I want to talk a little bit about this side door. They integrated this into the boat design in 2016. This boat was actually designed around this door, as opposed to a lot of manufacturers. They retrofit a hull design with a side door. This will help decrease the chances of spider cracking and structural issues. They also reinforce it with a thick stainless steel plate along the edges here. As I move aboard this boat, I can point out some features back here towards the transom. You've got a nice swim platform with marine mat. It's a lot nicer on your feet as opposed to non-skid. We have a pass-through jump seat here. You can see the seat folds up. It does fold down for easy entry. And as you come aboard, I'll point out some more features back here. A feature that C-Fox has had on the 266 and 288 for years is this folding bench. I like this a whole lot. It allows us to use it when the family's riding. You can also stow it away and use this as a combing device for fishing or as a leaning post to access your live well here. But it also gives us access under this hatch to all your pumps. Now this boat is equipped standard with EPS, and that allows us to integrate autopilot systems with ease, and generally that doesn't cost a whole lot because of the EPS already being on board. Another improvement C-Fox did here is they removed the pass-through jump seat on the port side. It was not even needed since we had the side door over here. That allowed them to incorporate this massive aquarium live well. This is a pressurized system. This one is as well. This is a thoroughbred fishing machine, as you can see. One thing you may or may not be able to notice is the technology that C-Fox has integrated into their manufacturing process over the last couple of years. For instance, on this particular boat, just over last year's design, these fish boxes have a core lid, and it's a one-piece design and a solid, whereas used to it had a two-piece press design, and that would cause for uneven gapping and waviness, and when you stood on it, it didn't feel as solid. Another thing that they've done is they've integrated CNC technology into cutting these parts out for this boat for precision gapping. So moving forward into the helm area, we'll talk about some of the features of this leaning post here. Lebrock seats are standard. These are very nice, well-made seats. We have powder-coated and stainless hinges and fold-away armrest. And you've got one center here as well. This leaning post up front has two drawers for storage. And you also have hatch here for battery access, which makes it very nice. Now moving back here, we'll move back a little bit. We've got fresh water access on this side and raw water access on this side. Moving forward to the helm here, C-Fox has decluttered this whole setup. They moved everything down from the command link gauges to your recess switches. We have a nice big black acrylic panel here. We can recess two 12-inch units in this, and it looks really clean with a black surround. Moving down here, we've got your trim tab switches. We have a tilt helm that's standard on this boat. Your dual binnacle, of course. Little storage box area for your battery switches. We've got a 12-volt outlet here and USB and auxiliary power as well. Down here we have a nice footrest, but this footrest is just like the new 248. It does have a backlit surround, which is very nice at night. You also have a footrest here that stows away. Moving up here, this is the new Ultima hardtop. They lowered the profile. We've still got two electronics back boxes, one forward and aft. We have a recessed panel here for your switches, for your spreader lights, your misters, etc. This particular top has two spreaders on the sides and two aft. But we also have a nice big rigid LED light bar up front. And that is a rigid industry product, so it is a premium unit. Another thing I want to talk about in this new hardtop is the sunroof. That's a very nice feature. I believe that's a Lumar product, so we know it's of great quality. Right here, we have another black acrylic panel for recessing your VHF stereo. Here is one of two Mister nozzles. Then moving back here, we've got two King holders here, and we've got five center rod holders. Now, with those five, this boat has a total of 20 rod holders. This is a ultimate fishing machine. I want to talk about this leaning post. Back here we have a very nice bait station. Lots of storage. All this is standard on this boat. This is not an option. Below this we have a sliding Yeti cooler. It's on a hydraulic slide. It's a nice feature. Easy access. So I'm inside of this 288 console. I'm 6 foot and I'm standing up. There's a lot of overhead space in here. This console is fully finished. No raw fiberglass. It's a fully lined console. They did a very nice job here. We've got a nice centralized house electrical panel. I've got a couple JL audio amplifiers neatly mounted here. Easy access to the backside of the electronics we would install. We have overhead LED lighting. Back this way we have a freshwater sink. And the toilet I'm sitting on has an overboard discharge. Moving forward, we've got a brand new coffin box design. They've contoured this, raised it to make it more form-fitting. You've got adjustable armrest here on each side. We've also got a really deep box, as you can see. And it does have built-in drains. Something that I have not mentioned yet is the marine mat on the bottom side of every deck lid on this boat. And that serves a purpose for gasket and an anti-vibration material. And it will hold up a lot better than trying to glue a gasket around the edge of all these boxes. Storage is abundant in this boat. We also have a lot of storage up here in the bow. You've got two boxes on each side of the boat. They are using the marine mat under this as well, but they also have a stainless strut on each one to hold the box lid open. And they're doing that on every box lid on this boat. We also have a recessed casting net bucket down here for more storage. Moving forward here, we've got an excellent bow set up for the family. Where I'm standing right now, it is an option to do a bow filler board. We didn't do it on this particular boat, but essentially that will fill in this as kind of a sun pad for the ladies. They still integrated the scallop seating. The combing board runs back all the way back to this recessed backrest. You got nice big stainless steel hinges here, and it folds right back up into the combing board. They did a recessed bow rail here. We've got plenty of cup holders throughout this boat. And moving forward here, we've got the anchor locker. This boat is standard with a Profish Lumar. I think it's the Profish 700. They also did the marine mat underneath here, which is a nice feature. If you're in the market for a saltwater fishing machine with all the modern amenities to accommodate the family, the 288 Commander should be on your short list. And at Avalanche Motorsports, it costs less too.
Hi, I'm Pam Anderson, President-elect of the Noon Rotary in Washington, North Carolina, and coordinator for our biggest annual fundraiser, the Smoke on the Water Barbecue and Chili Festival. In 2012, when this local festival was beginning to flounder, our Noon Rotary group took over the reins and made it a service project. Now, in its 19th year, and under the direction of the Washington Noon Rotary, it has grown and blossomed into the successful event it is today. Although I would not recommend this event for a small group, if you have the kind of community that we do, who will get behind your Rotary group and volunteer at the festival, then this may be the type of project that your Rotary group would be interested in. It has the potential to become your biggest fundraiser too.
With our cookers, our vendors, and other nonprofit groups, Smoke on the Water has an excellent reputation. We also have a proven track record of being successful and for giving back to the community. Every penny we make goes back to local nonprofit groups serving vital social, economic, and environmental causes, such as our food pantry, our women's shelter, the cancer center, even our high school band.
How much money have you raised in the past?
Oh my gosh, I can't even tell you. I know that we've given between $10,000 and $12,000 away every year from this event, so a big boost to the economy here.
This past year, we more than doubled our previous year's figures, not only in participants, but in money raised. That means our Rotary group will be helping 20 nonprofit groups in our area with a significant contribution this year.
And thank you for publicizing this, because you know every penny that we make goes out to some organization or charity that just needs help in this community.
Some needy recipients, mm-hmm. For sure.
There are committee chairmen for every aspect of the festival, and almost everyone in our club of 75 plus helps or volunteers in some way. Then the rest is done by volunteers in the community, many who are involved with the nonprofit groups who will be receiving donations.
I think that you could ask any one of our Rotarians about the feeling of giving back to the community, and this takes, it's a team. It's a group of 75 Rotarians who come out and work day from the time they get here for 2 days to the time they leave tomorrow. And it's just a great feeling to get back to the community and know that the need is so great and that we're able to help with it.
One of our secrets for success is to serve as the backdrop for local charities and other nonprofit groups to hold their fundraisers at during the event, so that they can capitalize on the attendance we get, and we in turn benefit in food sales from the extra attendance that these events attract. It's a win-win for everyone. 2 years ago, we added dragon boat races. After seeing my very first one, I knew this would be a perfect fit for Smoke on the Water. So I met with their coordinator, we made sure that our site was usable for this type of an event, and then we approached Sound Rivers, a local nonprofit group, and asked them if they would run the races as a fundraiser for themselves.
It just seemed like a natural fit to support the dragon boat races, Sound Rivers, and of course, the Noon Rotary's Smoke on the Water. I mean, this Smoke on the Water event is an iconic event for Washington. And when you think about so many people that just love Washington and love this area, and it's that passion that really drives them and gives them the energy to do an event like this. Otherwise, how do you get all these people, you know, out here and, you know, all together, working together to roast pigs, to have dragon boat races, to have vendors? I mean, this is, everybody across the county comes.
It's really an eclectic event, isn't it?
It's a great event. I mean, I think it's a model.
Now, dragon boat races are a fan favorite at our Smoke on the Water Festival.
Well, the dragon boat race here, this is the second year they've had it. Last year it was a small thing. This year there's 15 teams competing, and we're Healing Dragons from Charlotte, North Carolina, and we're a cancer survivor team, And what else do you need to know?
Well, how many members to a team?
20 people on a team. You get 10 people paddling per side. And a drummer. We have a drummer here. And a steers person in the back. So 22 total.
That's fantastic. So you come all the way from Charlotte.
That's right. Sure. So we're excited to be here this year. It's really nice. We came for the barbecue and the chili. That's why we're here.
Thrilled to have you. Welcome to Washington.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Good luck.
It's an event that's fun for the whole family and also fun to participate in. The Fire Truck Pull is a fundraiser for the Beaufort County Development Center. A crowd favorite, the Fire Truck Pull pits one group of firefighters against another in a challenge to see who can pull the fire engine the farthest in a set amount of time. The Pancake Breakfast is a fundraiser for our Civitan group, and the Duck Race is a fundraiser for our Pamlico Pals. This past year, we added the Kids Zone, and it proved to be a very popular area.
My name's Lisa Woolard, and I'm the director of the Beaufort Hyde Partnership for Children when I'm not a Rotarian. And of course, it's just natural that the Kids Zone would be something that I would be helping to coordinate. We have a little bit of something for everyone. There's a storybook theater over there. Patch Clark and her kids from ECU are putting on a great show, a fun time for the kids to be able to enjoy, and it's interactive as well.
Games, prizes, bounce houses, a train ride, storybook theater, and an art contest contributed to lots of giggling and happy children. And best of all, it was free to the kids. The art contest was held to help promote the Beaufort County Arts Council's annual Fine Arts Show, which happens at the same time as our festival. We also have a classic car show, and it has been a part of Smoke on the Water from the very start. Our patrons love to stroll along our beautiful waterfront and check out these automobiles. And what would a festival be without great music? We have a variety of musical styles reflected throughout the day. Young and old alike enjoy a little foot stomping. Although our actual job with the festival starts months earlier with obtaining sponsors to help support the event and meeting with the city to make sure things like street closings and everything are taken care of, early Friday morning, we meet out in the parking lot and rope off the area for the incoming participants and vendors. Cookers start arriving and begin their setup in spaces that we have pre-measured and marked the day before. Some contestants go the extra mile and decorate their cooking site in the barbecue contest to participate in a showmanship competition. The winner gets a trophy, cash prize, and bragging rights.
Tell us your name, sir.
Joe Peterson.
Joe Peterson. Well, I've already heard that name a few times today in all the other interviews I've done. In fact, I think Charlie Meeks mentioned it to me when I was talking with him.
Yeah, Charlie won the charcoal last year, and I won the gas cooking contest last year.
Now you going for gas again?
Yeah, going for gas again.
Then following the showmanship judging, the pigs are distributed to the sites where they are cleaned, trimmed, and prepared for cooking.
We're proud to be part of it. Smithfield did a good job getting these hogs together. They're beautiful pigs. We were proud to be a processor of these pigs. It's a good event. It's the biggest one that we've participated in. Over 30 pigs this year and over 30 participants. Wonderful evening to cook a pig. Beautiful time, beautiful people. Great time to do it.
Prior to being placed on the grill, festival authorities visit each site to inspect the condition of their meat prior to the cooking. Festivities actually begin Friday night with a meeting of the chief cooks of the barbecue contest, where the order for judging is determined. Then it's off to the pig parade, a comical sight of Rotarians donning pig noses and weeping for the sacrifice of their comrade for the next day's festival. This takes place at the start of the city's monthly Music in the Streets, a Friday night event.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, Jim.
Hey, what's happening?
Yeah, we're feeling good about it. We've had a good time. The weather's been perfect.
Yes.
We got to hang out with a lot of good guys all night and got to know them, so it was
fun.
Part. Yeah, it was fun. It was okay. Fun. Win or lose, it was fun.
I'm glad you guys could make it.
Yes, sir.
Part of this.
Yes, sir. Enjoying it.
This is a traditionally cooked whole hog, cooked over either hardwood or charcoal.
Okay, how's that differ from in terms of judging on the gas from the gas?
Typically, when you're cooking over hardwood and charcoal, you're going to have a darker color. It's not going to be that golden color. It's going to be the smoke itself renders the pig much darker.
Uh-huh.
And of course, you get a smoke ring A lot of times the pink that you see in here is not that it's undercooked, it's the smoke ring, the pig taking on the characteristics of the smoke, and of course the smoke flavor is very prominent as well. And you're not going to be able to crisp up the skin like you can with gas, because with a gas cooker, you can run up the temperature late in the cooking process to crisp up the skin. So it's a trade-off. The meat actually tastes better, I think, cooked in traditional method, but you just can't get that skin crisp. So, you know.
So that's my problem.
Yeah, you can't. It's hard to have the best of both worlds.
Tell us a little bit about the North Carolina Pork Council.
Well, the Pork Council has been around quite a while, and it's really helping all the farmers in North Carolina. They got a very strong organization. It's very well maintained and very well run by Deborah Johnson. It's got a lot of support among all of its members. And it's events like this that really showcase what the farmers do in North Carolina in all aspects of farming.
And the council is gets behind and helps promote these kinds of whole hog cook-offs.
Oh, absolutely. They are the organization that actually runs the whole hog competition cook-offs. And they have a board that sets the rules that all cookers have to follow in all of the contest. So it's a very well-run organization. Very organized, and it runs just very, very smoothly.
Now, how would you advise other Rotarians or Rotary organizations if they wanted to conduct their own pig cooking, say across the country, in
Correct.
Other states? What would you recommend they do?
With the respect and the organization that the North Carolina Pork Council has, they would need to get in touch with Miss Ann Edmondson in Raleigh at the North Carolina Pork Council. She is the lead person that actually is in charge of the whole hog competitions, and she can help anyone that would like to get into this, and she will bend over backwards to make sure that it's a success the first time they have one, and she wants to see it continue to grow.
Been up all night cooking this beautiful hog for you. Hopefully we'll do something, but we're here to meet people and have a good time. And we come a long way to do this because we have fun, we enjoy doing it. And if you want some barbecue, a good barbecue cooked the old way, get your butt down here to Little Washington.
Well, y'all have done a fantastic job. It's a good bunch of folks that throw it, you know, that throw the event. Pam does a good job putting it together. You guys do a good job in making sure that it's coordinated well, and we're just proud to be a part of it.
Smoke on the Water is just one of those festivals where everyone's having a good time. Neighbors are conversing, kids are laughing, and people are enjoying great award-winning food. The contestants love our festival. We offer very competitive prize money, big trophies, and the prettiest setting for overnight cooking.
Well, just glad to win it, man, and glad to do it down here. This place is real, real nice, and they deserve the good weather down here, you know. So I'm glad you got a good turnout, and it's a good place to come do it.
Vendors love to return to our festival because they're usually successful due to the number of people who attend the event, and they like being out on the waterfront as well.
Well, I've been coming for years and years, but just in the last 2 years, it has really doubled. It seems like every year we get more and more business. And it's a pleasure to do it in the hometown, really. And last year I was here and it doubled from the year before. So I run out of ice cream. And I think this year is going to, same thing going to happen because there's so many more people out here this year. It's amazing. It's amazing at the crowd. It's just local people. I mean, I get hugs and everything from, they're local people. But I know there's got to be a lot of people coming from out of town.
Would you recommend this festival to other vendors who might want to participate next year?
Most definitely. Most definitely. I see it growing every year, man.
Our sponsors are dedicated and return year after year due to the tremendous impact that their contribution makes to the community. This past year, we had three major sponsors: Potash Corp, Smithfield, and Tut Media Group. Also, we had numerous other sponsors who made this festival possible. We could not do this without their support.
Would you advise a Rotarian, a Rotary organization to take this kind of project on?
Sure. We're going to do that this year. We're making a handbook, and you're doing a documentary, so we can put it all together and hand it to them on a silver plate and say, hey, take it and run with it and make money for your community, too.
You can find out more about Smoke on the Water online at www.smokeonthewater.info or by calling 252-944-6136.
If you're interested in planning a festival in your area, call us. We'll be happy to share our experience and expertise with any other Rotary group wishing to make an impact in their community.
Hey guys, this is Ross with Avalanche Motorsports in Washington, North Carolina, and today we're bringing the boat show to you. We're going to talk about the new Seafox 248 Commander. Seafox did a great job of upgrading the already awesome 246 Commander, and we're going to talk about those upgrades today. First thing that we're going to show you today is on the 248, Seafox put the through-hole anchor pulpit with chafing plate, so you can set up a windlass system or you can just hang your front anchor off of here. Now, Seafox does a great job with this boat. If you look on this boat, the dead rise on this boat is 18 degrees, but it only drafts 14 inches. So you're getting a hull design that can really handle it all, whether you're going out in the ocean, you're chasing fish, or if you're doing sandbar cruising or really anything in between, this design can do it all. Seafox is famous for this huge Carolina flare that's on the front of this boat. Not only does it look good, but it serves a purpose. This big Carolina flare is going to keep you dry if you're riding through some pretty rough water or chop or things like that. And it just makes the ride of this boat phenomenal. On this Seafox, the color combination that we chose for this boat was the jetty gray side hole color with the matching powder coating on your leaning post and your T-top. Seafox does a great job of offering a lot of different color combinations and also different setups for where you can put the color on the boat so you can really make it a boat that's your boat and designed for you. Moving along to the back here, you've got a big swim platform with the faux teak, which feels really nice on your feet, swim ladder, and this boat's equipped with the Yamaha XB250 motor. This is a 4.2 liter. It's built on the same block as the 300, and the reason why we ordered this boat with this 250 is because performance wise it's 53 mile an hour machine. It's going to get great fuel economy compared to previous designs, and it's going to get you up on plane fast, super dependable and super quiet. Now, where Seafox really upgraded this boat on the new 248 compared to the 246 was back here in the back. They just did a great job with this layout. You got a three safety system, pass-through seat, so little Billy doesn't fall through the back of it when you're getting ready to take the kids out for wakeboarding. You got a deep box here that you can put ice, any type of storage access so you can get to it from the back of the boat. And the fishermen are going to love this setup back here with your fresh water and your raw water washdown. This is a new design from Seafox. You have your access there for your fresh water with the hose. And then over here you have your access for your raw water so you can get that blood off the boat when you start pulling the fish in. Now, moving on to the back here, you got your ski tow bar that's removable, but it's a great option to have for a boat that functions as family boat and fishing boat. And then you've got storage for your net. Now, why are you going to need that net there? Well, I'm going to tell you why you're going to need that net there. You're going to need the net here to get the fish out of your pressurized aquarium style live well, which is an awesome upgrade that Seafox did to the previous 246 Commander. The area that you lost in the 246 by having your pressurized live well here, you actually gain over here with the new fish box. It's got a nice fish box. It's got storage past this point so you can really get some big fish down in there. Okay, now moving forward, we're gonna go to the helm area for the cockpit. And this boat just shines with all the things that they've done to it. We're gonna start with this console. Couple of changes that they made the windshield a little bit bigger so you've got more protection for whatever type of fishing or adventures that you go on with this boat. Also, you see all your switches have been mounted low, and what that does is that clears up a ton of console space, so you could essentially put two 12-inch screens in this boat and you've got a really nice rig. We are full Simrad, Raymarine, and Garmin dealer. We can hook you up with whatever you want. And if you buy the boat from us, we put them in for free. Moving forward up here, this top is awesome. This thing has a ton of storage and functionality. You've got box here, and a box back here. Sunroof, Mr. Pumps. Everybody's been out on the boat when it's 102 degrees and the wind's not blowing and the baby's crying, and you got to have the Mr. Pumps because it's going to blow out a cool mist out of this area, out of your freshwater tank. Now, for the fishermen are going to love the rod holder storage on this. You've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 rod holders just in this area, not to mention the two that are on each side of the boat and the two that are in the back. The top is set up, ready to go. If you want to rig your outriggers up here, we can certainly do that for you. Just a ton of storage, light, and protection from this console. Another thing that I really like of what Seafox has done is they've made this Leaning Prost more low profile, so you've got more floor space to move around the boat, but you're not sacrificing comfort. When you're back in this area, I've got a good solid leaning post. I've got two positions that I can put my feet there. I also have a bar down here that I can put my feet. And then when I'm ready to cruise, just move that down and I'm good to go. And I've got a really comfortable ride. Pair that up with the tilt steering wheel and man, you've got an awesome setup here. In your center console, when you get the hard top, you automatically get the kicker sound system with all the speakers that we'll show you later. You have all your accessory switches, including underwater LED lights, mood lights, freshwater, washdown pump, aerator pump, bilge pump, etc. On this boat comes standard with your trim tab, so you have your switches there for that. And then, of course, your Yamaha gauges. Moving down, here is your battery cutoff. You don't have to worry about going and hunting and getting in a hole to turn your batteries on and off. This boat is pre-rigged with two batteries. Here you've got 12 volt and USB charging area that you can hook that up and play music through your phone. Down here, these footrests, they are lit and they look awesome at night. Now ladies and gentlemen, you may have noticed I haven't missed very many meals. I eat my Wheaties and take my vitamins and I'm a big dude and I can still sit in this console. Got a porta potty. There is the option for an electric toilet if that's something that you wanted to do as well, but this console has got tons of room. And with the Seafox, you know, this boat's going to have a lot of cushions in it. You're going to have a lot of cushions for when you want to ride the family in this boat. And I can tell you, every cushion and accessory fits in this center console, which is really nice for storage. Also on the console door, you see, this is locking, so you do have some lockable storage in here. And then Seafox made this a twin hinge design. It's got a magnet in there, so it's really easy to open and close this door. And you also got a Seafox bottle opener for any non-adult beverages. Moving forward to the front here, on this T-top, man, this T-top is just awesome. Fire extinguisher storage, it's a great place to put it. It's out of the way, but you can get to it quick. You also have spreader lights on this top. You have one here on the front, you have two aft, and then you have one on each side. In the hard top, you've got speakers mounted, you've got speakers down here in the floor. I mean, this is just a really awesome setup that Sea Fox has done with this boat. Now, Sea Fox has always been family in the front and fishing in the back. And with this design, that still holds true, but it kind of defies that as well. You see, you've got a full sun pad up here, as well as Sea Fox did something really cool with their Conan boards. On the 266 Commander, they took that design, and your Conan board actually folds back into a backrest, so you can face forward, or you can face back, or you can have one of each, and you can have a conversation. Now, while I say this also defies a little bit of that family in the front, fishing in the back mentality, is because once you remove this pad, you can use this as a casting platform if you're fishing off the front of the boat as well. The design on this was just really, really well thought out, and it shows. You've got the scallop seating up front. This will actually go up, and you put a pole in, and you have a table for the front. Down here in this storage, you have storage for a full bucket that you can put a cast net in or anything else like that. And then you've still got your dual front seats here up front. So as far as if you're trying to have fun, or if you're trying to fish, or if you're trying both, this boat's got you covered. In closing, if you can't decide if you want a fishing boat or if you want a fun family boat, this is definitely a boat you need to look at, guys, because this thing does it all, and it does it all better than anybody else. And at Avalanche Motorsports, it costs less too.
Coming in there is Miss Liz and Miss Audrey. Chubby's carpet.
Hello.
Say good morning.
Good morning.
You guys want to show us around a little bit?
You bet.
Have an idea what you got going on?
Yep, I will just start you out with some of our carpets we've got here. We've got your Mohawk, we've got Shaw, we've got your Anderson Cuffex. Do want you to know that we've got some displays here where we've got our nylons, we've got our polyesters here, we've got some of our prints, one of our favorites here. This is for your stairs. If you'd like to do a stair runner, I can make a stair runner for you.
Is the prints coming back?
Yes, they are.
Are they really?
They're beautiful. And we do custom bind. Remember that. If you come in here and you've got hardwood floors and you want an area rug, we can custom bind that for you.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Also, I'm just taking you around to our commercial carpet display. If you've got a sunroom, or if you've got an office, a business, we do also commercial jobs. We've got carpet tiles and broadloom. Got our at least two or three displays here when we do that. And we also do ceramic tile remodels. We also do backsplashes. So my favorite, if you have a tub that needs to be taken out, even a ceramic tile or a just a regular acrylic tub, and you want to come back with a walk-in shower, or just the tub surround, I can help you decorate that and customize that for you.
Liz, are you seeing a lot of remodeling going on there?
More than ever. People are coming in, new construction, but a lot of remodeling. And they're coming in here, and they did not know that Chubby's did ceramic tile remodels. So that's what we're doing a lot of now.
Well, I've heard a lot of people talking about redoing their kitchens and baths, mm-hmm. So that's a fact.
We do, and a lot of people are actually taking out their old countertops and putting in granite, and we're coming back and I'm helping them coordinate their granite to a new backsplash.
Gotcha.
So yeah, we do a lot of that.
We all stay plenty busy.
Yes, we do.
You do some of everything.
We do. So we actually do, I like to show people a lot of our tiles. We have a lot of custom tiles here. Porcelain. We've got some glass that we also use. I like to use a lot of these accent pieces when I'm creating your new shower, your new Listello. We also can install your niche in the back of your shower so you have a special place for your shampoo and conditioner. We've also got stone here if you want to do your fireplace. So we've got a nice array of stone here to look at.
And Miss Audrey's over there on the newest product you got.
This is my assistant, Audra.
Hello.
She helps me sell a lot of the newest floor today is luxury vinyl plank. And this is Mannington's Aduramax. We sell more of this. It's an 8mm product. It is scratch resistant, water resistant, has a lifetime residential, has a 10-year light commercial. We just put it in this huge hardware store. So it's tough.
Yeah, I've heard a lot of people talking about that. That's kind of the hottest thing on the street right now in the construction industry.
Yep, and it comes in 12 by 24 tiles. Just know that this is a floating floor. The great thing about it, if you've got vinyl on the floor now and you don't want to do a lot of prep work to it, you can float this right across your floor.
Does it click, pop, and snap when people are walking on it?
No. That's one thing it will not do. It's not going to do like what a laminate, what we've always used to hearing, that echoey tap sound that it gives. This is going to be more of a solid, and it's actually warmer. And most of my new construction, about 90% of my new construction, this is what they're doing.
Gotcha.
Instead of hardwood floors, because of their grandbabies. Because of the kids, because of the dogs, the cats, they don't have to worry about it. So we got tile looks for your bathrooms, kitchens, utility rooms. Then we've got all these wood planks.
Quite a variety.
Warm, nice cool grays if you want to do that. A lot of beachy looks for a lot of the beach houses.
Mm-hmm.
It's beautiful. We've also got it in the water plank form if you want to do that. And I don't want people to forget that if you don't want to do a luxury vinyl plank, we've got vinyl sheet goods.
Gotcha.
Most of our vinyl sheet goods come 12 foot. You can get 13-2 wide, which is really cool because it's good for your single wides or your double wides or your modulars. So we customize and help you do that so you won't have seams in your vinyl.
So you guys can help most anybody with your flooring needs.
Yeah, you bet.
Well, that's good.
It's
a one-stop shop.
And I'll show you one more thing that we do.
All right.
We customize and pre-finish hardwood floors.
Customize and pre-finish?
Yep, pre-finished.
So okay.
We've got your hickories, your acacias, your maples. I've got your standard white oak, your red oak. If you want to do an engineered or if you want to do a solid, we take pride in this particular brand because of it being a half-inch engineered. And it's made in the USA.
Well, that's awesome. What kind of warranties it got with it?
This has a 50-year structural warranty on it.
That's great.
Yeah.
Well, guys, we appreciate your time today. And
thank you.
If you need anything in the flooring, come see these gals.
Come see us at Chubby's.
We'll do it. And thank you. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I do want to show you their board with all their projects they have going on as we speak. And they can get to you. So guys, appreciate it. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Hey guys, this is Ross at Avalanche Motorsports in Washington, North Carolina. And today we're doing our review of the flagship of the C-Fox fleet, the C-Fox 328 Commander. Come on, let's go take a look. Okay guys, the first thing that I want to show you on this C-Fox is the massive Carolina flare that it has. Makes this boat a super dry ride. Going over a few quick measurements, the boat measures exactly 32 feet long. It has a 10-foot, 8-inch beam and a dead rise of 22.5 degrees. This is an offshore machine that's capable for anything that you want to throw at. Okay, moving on, we want to talk a little bit about the hull of the C-Fox. First of all C-Foxes are built in Monk's Corner, South Carolina. These boats aren't just designed, but they're engineered to be safe and last a lifetime. That's why C-Fox was one of the first boat manufacturers out there to offer a lifetime hull warranty. There's no wood in this boat, which means there's not going to be any type of rot. C-Fox utilizes high quality 316 stainless steel through hull fittings, and the 328 boasts the notched hull back design, which will give you the best performance possible. Now, at the back of the boat, C-Fox has integrated a dive door. And what makes C-Fox different from a lot of boat builders is a lot of boat builders will design a hull, then cut a hole in it and put a door. Seafox designs the hull around the door so you have lots of structure and backing in there to assure that you don't run into spider cracking and issues like that down the road. Moving to the back of the boat here, we see this boat is powered with twin Yamaha digital 300s. Max horsepower on this boat is 700, so you could do 350s. This boat as it sits is about a 52, 53 mile an hour boat. With the 350s, 57 mile an hour boat. Back here you have a lot of attention to detail and design. Seafox recesses all of their trim tabs on all their boats from 22 feet and up. And here you have your built-in integrated dive ladder so you can get on and off easy. This is where I want to spend all my time at when I'm on this boat, is back here in the area. Seafox is famous for having a boat that's extremely comfortable to have the family thing going on in the front and fishing in the back, and this just tells the tale. Back here you have a big comfortable bench seat, but with the flip of a lever, you've got a full combing device that you can lean up to and really get into the fish with. You have two large pressurized bait wells, keep your bait living for a long time and easy to get to, with an aquarium style live well over here as well. Now, down by your dive door, you have an insulated cooler box, which is nice. You can throw some drinks and water in there when you're going swimming. And then when you're ready to pull the big fish in, you've got four large macerated fish boxes here. With a total of 36 rod holders on this boat, Seafox definitely made this boat for the fishermen. All right, back here is the bait prep station. As you can see, this was really well thought out. You've got a flat area here, but you flip this over, you've got a cutting board, you have an area where you can keep your bait once it's all prepped and set up. You also have a sink here with a freshwater wash down as well. Then underneath, they did a really good job utilizing this space. All you have to do is press a button, and you've got easy access to your Yeti cooler. When you start opening compartments in this Seafox 328 Commander, you can tell that this boat was made for the angler. You have a really nice tackle station with drawers and line set up. Storage all through this center console area, and raw water wash down on this side and another fresh water wash down over on the starboard side. Okay guys, in the helm area, the first thing that you'll notice are these three comfortable race boat inspired LeBrock seats. There's several different armrest configurations and setups for using this as a leaning post or just cruising, with several areas to put your seat. If you can't get comfortable in this helm, then you can't get comfortable. Moving up to the hard top, this has a ton of storage in it. You have storage to the rear and up front. You have an acrylic glass panel here so you can mount a VHF radio. And when it comes to climate control in this boat features freshwater misters here and back here, and also has air conditioning that actually comes out of the console area and will keep you cool on those August days. Okay, touching some more on the helm area, everything is very smartly laid out already from Seafox. You've got two huge Garmin 7616 GPS units in here that'll provide you with medium, high chirp, fish finder, depth finder, everything you need to get on the fish and know where you're going. You got a smart switch panel down here that has everything you need access to. You have your Yamaha control center, EPS, and JL audio, all within hand's reach. Also, this boat comes standard with the Lenco trim tabs with the LED indicator, so you always know where your trim tabs are. Also, something that I like about the 328 is you have battery switches right here, easy to get to. You're never going to hop in your boat and have forgotten to turn on your battery switches. Okay guys, as you can see here, the bow area has a ton of room. It is fishing friendly. However, all you have to do is snap in a few cushions and you've got a bow area. for the most discerning of pleasure boaters. Look at this. You've got beautiful diamond stitching, super comfortable bow seating area, and with these snap back cushions, you can face forward or you can facing backwards and have a nice conversation here, have your wine and cheese. It's all good to go. My favorite spot on the boat was back there in the bait area. This is my second favorite spot of the boat. Up front, beautiful view, and believe it or not, even in rough water, this seat rides good. Circling back around to this T-top, one thing that Seafox does is they build all of their T-tops in-house. This T-top is fabricated for this boat. It's not an afterthought. It's not something that's subbed out to a different company. This is a Seafox boat with a Seafox top on it. You've got integrated lights all the way around. You have awesome storage for fire extinguishers and Coast Guard safety equipment. You have your freshwater mister system, and you have brackets preset for taco outriggers. So all you have to do is basically bolt them up and they're ready to go. Guys, for those of you who know me, I'm not a small guy. Seafox does a great job of making plenty of walk around room around here. You can get easy access to any one of the 36 rod holders that are on this boat. And it's really set up for fishing. You have the ability to fish this boat anywhere that you want all the way around. I want you to take a look at the size of this console and this Seafox 328 Commander. You have an electric flushing head with overboard discharge. You have a large berth, and Seafox even air conditions this console. That's right, you have an air conditioner control that will allow you to control the temperature in here. Super, super clean layout. You've got your amplifiers for your JL Audio sound system here. You have access to all your breakers, circuits, and switches, and then access to the back to get to your electronics. This was really well thought out and super useful. So ladies and gentlemen, in closing, if you're looking for a fishing machine that's capable of taking you anywhere you want to go, catching all the fish, but without sacrificing any type of luxury or comfort, you need to put the Seafox 328 Commander on your short list. And at Avalanche Motorsports, it costs less too.
Thanks for watching our video. If this information was helpful to you, click the like button and check out our inventory on avalanche-motors.com.
Here in Washington, great tiki bar.
Well, I've been coming here since 2005, and it's day in, day out. It's the most consistent, best food in town.
Hearing that. Thank you
there
so much.
So
come and see us.
Come see us. There we go. We're going to walk around and shoot everybody.
All right.
See the smiles on everybody's face. We're going to play the ring game.
Oh, wait. Let's
go. Yeah.
For Washington.
Absolutely.
This is the original. 1776.
Make the ring for us. One dime. Great place for all ages. She's trying to knock the light pole down. She'll get it directly. Overlooking the river.
There's the Pemigo River out there. And there's the boat ramp, the city boat ramp.
And there's Backwater Jacks. There we go, two stories. Lots of bar room, lots of people. Now we're gonna get what we're doing
in here.
Huh?
Come on inside.
All right. Going on the inside.
This is the original house before any of the decks were built.
Absolutely. I remember it well. Ladies first.
Thank you.
I'm old school. That ain't changing.
Okay, give us a smile, Dylan. This is Dylan, the bartender of the night.
That's right.
Been wheeling, dealing, slinging drinks all around.
And I'll vouch for him. He makes a good drink. Lime and rum and 7-Up.
All right, that's what I'm talking about.
That's a great drink.
Yeah, I
maybe
wouldn't go all the way in, but you probably
could.
Don't go all the way in.
Yeah, just enough to see. This is where all the good food comes
from. Can you turn it off a second?
Huh?
So I can pull out some the crew.
No, I really can't. Go ahead. We'll keep shooting. Even got TV. see what the weather's going to be tomorrow. Got an ATM machine, no credit cards. Bring your car and get cash and pay for a great experience and good food. Here we can.
Okay.
Alrighty.
As soon as they got a minute, they're going to come out.
Alright.
And give them a big wave. There's two guys working hard at the grill right now.
Hey, they did great. That chicken sandwich is awesome.
Their griddle is not any wider than this.
Really?
And they put all that food out of that kitchen.
I'm not a big fan of chicken.
There they go. Wave, Miss Jess.
Come on, my baby. Say
this
hey.
Miss Jess.
Come here and say hey. Don't be bashful. We all do a great job. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, walk through the here. Walk through the dining room.
You want to go through this way?
Yeah. I know that fella, Mr. Merle Moore.
Yes, sir.
How you doing, man?
We're always glad when you bring your crew in.
How you going?
Good, how you doing?
Been a while.
Good. Mr. Mike?
Yeah.
Mike Baker, you ain't recognize me.
Mike!
Yeah, man.
Oh,
how you doing? Hey.
I know it. Going with the wind.
Man, we're getting a little older now.
I know me.
Things change.
What are you up to nowadays? Retired?
No, man. Having fun.
I hear you.
Right now, you're on YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter. Yeah, we're kind of shooting a thing for the guys here. Yeah, remember I was at the truck ride the other night. That was awesome. Yeah, man. Catch up with me a little bit. I've seen bro twice today. What did I see you today?
I don't think so.
Did he? Yeah, look at that. That's having fun at Backwater Jack.
You better know it.
Everybody in here is quiet. They're eating. Or have eaten, taking a nap. Here we are going to the bar area. You got pretty red hair. How you doing?
Hey guys, today we're at Avalanche Motorsports and we're going to talk about the all new 2018 C-Fox 266 Commander. So this boat screams C-Fox. Big flared out bow, signature stripe built into the hull. This particular boat is finished in aquamarine, which is a new color for 2018. We've got aquamarine under the hard top, white powder coating, white custom painted engines. Moving back here, of course we've got the recessed trim tab pockets, underwater LEDs. That's the LED package that comes with additional mood lighting inside the cockpit. This particular boat's equipped with twin 150 XB motors, super fuel efficient. I've got one of these boats myself. It averages about 3 miles to the gallon, cruising at about 3,500 RPMs. Makes for a great package. This boat is also available starting with a single 300 motor. We can also do a 350. Of course, again, this boat's got twin 150s. It's available with 200s as well in both XB and XCA configurations. So as I move aboard this boat, right here just in front of the motor well area, we've got an optional ski tow bar. We've got four large rod holders here. I'm standing on a pass-through jump seat. It folds up and down. We've got a nice stepped area here to make entry and exit super easy. Just between the two jump seats, we've got a 55-gallon aerated live well. And it's round. It's going to do a great job keeping the bait alive. So just in front of the live well here, we've got this rear jump seat with a combing board. While you're fishing, you can fold this flat. Makes for a larger available space back here. For cruising, we'll fold it up so we have additional seating.
Just under this is access to your all your pumps. It's fully finished, fully gel coated. Just in front of this area, we've got two large hatches here. These are your insulated, macerated fish boxes. We'll move forward. We've got additional rod holders here in the leaning post. We got them all throughout the gunnel. This particular leaning post, my favorite position is with the bolsters folded up, used as a leaning post rather than a seat. This is the most comfortable position to me, but you can fold them down and you do have a footrest here. All brand new helm for 2018. They removed the center pod with all the switches and gauges and laid everything out below. Gave us a additional space for twin screens up to 16 inch. We've got your switch panel down here. Super easy to get to. Command link gauges. These particular motors again are mechanical, so this is standard. Your standard Kicker 8 speaker stereo, that is a Bluetooth model. We've got a C-Star tilt helm. Of course, this boat's equipped with two motors, so this is your dual binnacle. Just below that, we've got some a glove box here with charging access and audio input. All right, rod holders. So we've got seven out back here. We've got two kings, five center. This new hard top has four storage boxes, one forward, one aft, two on each side of the boat. It also has four spreader lights all the way around. It is pre-rigged for Taco outriggers. They did carry over the freshwater misting system that is standard in the hardtop. And this new sunroof is awesome. It opens and shuts. It just makes for a great streamlined hardtop. So when I'm fishing, I'm wondering where all my equipment is. On this particular boat, there's gonna be no question. On the starboard side of the console here, they've got this great tackle station. This is standard on the 266. So we've got six Plano boxes. We've got a nice shelf here, a drawer, and we've got spools for your lines there. So today I'm not going fishing. I'm taking the family out. I moved all my stuff out of the boat. We're going boat riding. Look at the bow here. This thing is family friendly in the front. Scallop seating, stowaway backrest for ease pass through. Folds right into these combing boards on each side here. You've got storage under each side of these cushions. We've got a casting net bucket recessed into the floor here. And oh my God, look at this coffin box. You've got storage for days and super comfy chairs. So I'm down here in the console. This thing has got ample space, great access behind the helm. The tub here is fully finished, gel coat. We've got a freshwater sink. This particular boat that I'm in now has a electronic toilet with overboard discharge, which is a very popular option. And this is new as well. They've got the bow filler board stowed away up top here. So in short, if you're headed to the lake, the river, or going offshore fishing, this 266 Commander should definitely be on your short list. And in Avalanche Motorsports, starting just under 90,000 NAP pricing, it costs less too. Thank you. Guys, it's Todd here with Avalanche Motorsports in Washington, North Carolina, and today we're going to talk about the all-new 2018 C-Fox 288 Commander. I want to point out the big broad bow here. This thing's got a ton of flair to it. They've integrated that Carolina flair. We've got a downward striking chine. This is a super dry riding boat. As you may or may not know, C-Fox is one of the only manufacturers on the market doing a lifetime hull warranty. That says we're confident in the product that we're building. This is a full composite boat. There's no wood, no rot, okay? There's a lot of manufacturers doing this, but it is a little bit of a fine line. C-Fox is actually doing composite stringers. It's a full composite. As boat. We move back here, I want to talk a little bit about the side door. They integrated this into the boat design in 2016. This boat was actually designed around this door, as opposed to a lot of manufacturers. They retrofit a hull design with a side door. This will help decrease the chances of spider cracking and structural issues. And also reinforce it with a thick stainless steel plate along the edges here. As I move aboard this boat, I can point out some features back here towards the transom. You've got a nice swim platform with marine mat. It's a lot nicer on your feet as opposed to non-skid. We have a pass-through jump seat here. You can see the seat folds up. It does fold down for easy entry. And as you come aboard, I'll point out some more features back here. A feature that Sea Fox has had on the 266 and 288 for years is this folding bench. I like this a whole lot. It allows us to use it when the family's riding. You can also stow it away and use this as a combing device for fishing or as a leaning post to access your live well here. But it also gives us access under this hatch to all your pumps. Now this boat is equipped standard with EPS, and that allows us to integrate autopilot systems with ease, and generally that doesn't cost a whole lot because of the EPS already being on board. Another improvement Sea Fox did here is they removed the pass-through jump seat on the port side. It was not even needed since we had the side door over here. That allowed them to incorporate this massive aquarium live well. This is a pressurized system. This one is as well. This is a thoroughbred fishing machine, as you can see. One thing you may or may not be able to notice is the technology that Sea Fox has integrated into their manufacturing process over the last couple of years. For instance, on this particular boat, just over last year's design, these fish boxes have a core lid, and it's a one-piece design and a solid, whereas used to it had a two-piece press design, and that would cause for uneven gapping and waviness, and when you stood on it, it didn't feel as solid. Another thing that they've done is they've integrated CNC technology into cutting these parts out for this boat for precision gapping. So moving forward into the helm area, we'll talk about some of the features of this leaning post here. Lebrock seats are standard. These are very nice, well-made seats. We have powder-coated and stainless hinges and fold-away armrest, and you've got one center here as well. This leaning post up front has two drawers for storage, and you also have hatch here for battery access, which makes it very nice. Now moving back here, we'll move back a little bit. We've got fresh water access on this side and raw water access on this side. Moving forward to the helm here, Sea Fox has decluttered this whole setup. They moved everything down from the command link gauges to your recess switches. We have a nice big black acrylic panel here. We can recess two 12-inch units in this. And it looks really clean with a black surround. Moving down here, we've got your trim tab switches. We have a tilt helm that's standard on this boat. Your dual binnacle, of course. Little storage box area for your battery switches. We've got a 12-volt outlet here and USB and auxiliary power as well. Down here we have a nice footrest, but this footrest is just like the new 248. It does have a backlit surround, which is very nice at night. You also have a footrest here that stows away. Moving up here, this is the new Ultima hardtop. They lowered the profile. We've still got two electronics boxes, one forward and aft. We have a recessed panel here for your switches, for your spreader lights, your misters, etc. This particular top has two spreaders on the sides and two aft. But we also have a nice big rigid LED light bar up front. And that is a rigid industry product, so it is a premium unit. Another thing I want to talk about in this new hardtop is the sunroof. That's a very nice feature. I believe that's a Lumar product, so we know it's of great quality. Right here, we have another black acrylic panel for recessing your VHF stereo. Here is one of two mister nozzles. Then moving back here, we've got two King holders here, and we've got five center rod holders. Now, with those five, this boat has a total of 20 rod holders. This is an ultimate fishing machine. I want to talk about this leaning post. Back here, we have a very nice bait station. Lots of storage. All this is standard on this boat. This is not an option. Below this, we have a sliding Yeti cooler. It's on a hydraulic slide. It's a nice feature, easy access. So I'm inside of this 288 console. I'm 6 foot and I'm standing up. There's a lot of overhead space in here. This console is fully finished, no raw fiberglass. It's a fully lined console. They did a very nice job here. We've got a nice centralized house electrical panel. I've got a couple JL audio amplifiers neatly mounted here. Easy access to the backside of the electronics we would install. We have overhead LED lighting. Back this way, we have a freshwater sink. And the toilet I'm sitting on has a overboard discharge. Moving forward, we've got a brand new coffin box design. They've contoured this, raised it to make it more form-fitting. You've got adjustable armrest here on each side. We've also got a really deep box, as you can see. It does have built-in drains. Something that I have not mentioned yet is the marine mat on the bottom side of every deck lid on this boat. And that serves a purpose for gasket and an anti-vibration material. And it will hold up a lot better than trying to glue a gasket around the edge of all these boxes. Storage is abundant in this boat. We also have a lot of storage up here in the bow. You've got two boxes on each side of the boat. They are using the marine mat under this as well, but they also have a stainless strut on each one to hold the box lid open. And they're doing that on every box lid on this boat. We also have a recessed casting net bucket down here for more storage. Moving forward here, we've got an excellent bow set up for the family.
got no kind of feeling inside. What I got will sure enough set your stuff off right. You refuse to put anything before your pride. And what I got will knock your pride shine. Tell something good. That you like it, yeah. Tell me something good.
Ooh. Tell me, tell me, tell me.
Tell me that you love me, yeah. Ain't got no time, that's what you're known to say. There were 48 hours to each day. Yeah. Problem is you ain't been loved like you should. And what I got will sort of do you good. Something good.
Ooh. Tell me, tell me, tell me.
Tell me that you like it, yeah. Tell me something good.
Ooh. Tell me, tell me, tell me.
Tell me that you love me, yeah. Tell me something good.
For feeling so lonely, I'm crazy, crazy for feeling so blue. I knew you loved me as long. Try.
trying and crazy for crying, and I'm crazy for loving you.
I think that
cool.
Was it.
Yeah, that was it.
I think oh, okay, I'm on the high part. I'll do that. Alright, hang on.
Okay.
Wishful thing. This is gonna be the hardest thing I do all day today. If I can not smile for it. Alright, just think about sad things.
Shine.
like it, yeah. Tell me something good.
Ooh. Tell me, tell me, tell me.
Tell me that you love me. Time, that's what you're known to say. I'll make you wish there were 48 hours to each day. Yeah. Your problem is you ain't been loved like you should. And what I got will sure look do you good. Tell me something good.
Tell me, tell me, tell me.
Tell me that you like it. Something good.
Leaves are falling all around. Darkest depths of Mordor. Please welcome Gary Clark Jr., Dave Grohl, and Joe Walsh.
Gently weep. I don't also younger than the sun. Yeah, that funny boat was won as we sail into the misty. Harden, now hear the sailors cry. Smell the sea and feel the sky. Let your soul and spirits fly into the misty. When that foghorn blows, I'll be coming home. Mm-hmm. When that foghorn blows, I wanna hear it. I don't have to fear it, and I wanna rock your gypsy soul, just like way back in the days of old. And magnificently we'll fold into the misty.
Come on, baby.
Let's just do it.
Okay. It doesn't sound that way.
Mississippi in the middle of a dry spell. Jimmy Rogers on the Victrola by. Mama's dancing with baby on her shoulders. The sun is setting like molasses in the sky. The book of sea knew how to move.
I just played a wrong chord.
Oh, okay.
When they all should let us be.
to my very soul. You're the light in my deepest, darkest hour. You're my savior when I fall. And you may not think that I care for you, when you know deep inside that I really do. And it's me you need to show.
I've got to find a change of scene.
Ooh.
Cause every night I had the strangest dream.
Ooh.
Imprisoned by the way
Ooh.
It could have been.
Ooh.
Left here on my own,
or
so it seems.
Ooh.
I got to leave before
Ooh.
I start to scream.
Ooh.
But someone locked the door
Ooh.
And threw the key. I'm feeling alright.
Oh,
I'm not feeling too good myself.
Oh,
oh, oh.
I'm feeling alright. Oh,
I'm not feeling too good myself.
Oh,
no, no.
Ooh.
Boy, you should've taken me
Ooh.
For a ride.
Ooh.
Even now I sit
Ooh.
And I wonder why.
Ooh.
And when I think of you, oh,
Ooh.
I start to cry.
Ooh.
I just can't waste my time.
Ooh.
I gotta stay down.
I'm so scared in case I fall off my chair.
'cause I don't think I can take anymore. Clowns to the left of me, jokers to the right, here I am stuck in the middle with you.
I think that's probably it.
All right, yeah. Sweet.
Right on, right on, right on.
Used to be, but since I met you, baby,